Finally, we got some news regarding One Piece Blood and Blood. And also, it's been a while since I made an update news video for One Piece Blood and Blood. But anyways, what is good? I mean, what is really good, my people? It is UK, Trotter Brother, Dr. Blood, the Darkest Man, around. And today, guys, I'll be talking about One Piece Blood and Blood and the news slash information for this game. But anyway, guys, get your fried chicken, get your Kool-Aid, and sit them cheeks down, because you definitely know, this UK, Trotter Brother will be going ham on this video. So without ado, let me just go. So first of all, I gotta start off by saying the DLC for One Piece Blood and Blood will be coming out the 22nd of December. Garp and Caesar will be coming out the 22nd of December, 3 days before Christmas. And me, I'm gonna get the DLC regardless, but my opinion has remained the same from when I made a video saying how the DLC is going to be structured. And what I mean by that is, in that video, I said that the way they structured the DLC for One Piece Blood and Blood, it looks like they're trying to stretch the lifespan of this game as long as possible. And obviously that is the case, because we're in a situation before this DLC got announced in terms of release date, we're in this situation saying that One Piece Blood and Blood is dead. Like, I'm still playing the game. In fact, I recently restarted up playing this game. Like, I'm starting to enjoy playing this game again. But in terms of them releasing in December, I still feel like it should have been November, not December, November. But anyways, the 22nd of December is when this DLC will be dropping. Me, I'm looking forward to playing as Garp and Caesar. If I had to pick one of the two, I'm looking forward to playing more than the other. I'm gonna pick Garp, in my personal opinion, because I like Garp more as a character than I do with Caesar. And then you gotta bear in mind, we still got them 5 mystery characters that are yet to be confirmed for this game. But as a whole, guys, I wanna know what you guys think about this DLC for One Piece Blood and Blood. Leave your thoughts and opinions down in the comment section below about that, because I wanna know what you guys think. And also, this may be one of the final update videos that I will do for this game. Like, me, Flash, Vengeful Wolfberg, Faname, when he was making One Piece videos, we covered this game from the beginning. It's been a bumpy road, like a hard ass road. And to be in this position that I'm almost at 2K, when I started covering Blood and Blood, I was at like less than 300 subscribers. And now I'm in a position almost at 2K. It's really amazing. And this game has helped me out a lot. Like, I cannot deny it. This game has helped me out a lot. And I'm grateful to be in this position to cover a game that I can actually get decent reception, and a game that helped me meet a lot of great people. But as a whole, guys, this may be one of the final One Piece Blood and Blood update news videos, because this game, like I said, is getting dry, it's getting kind of dead, and it's getting to the end of the cycle. And yeah, like, that's pretty much all I gotta say. So please comment and subscribe. I know I say this all the time, but at the end of the day, I'm just saying, please leave a like rating if you enjoyed this video. And yes, this UK, Trotter Brother, will catch you in the next one. Bye, guys. Work.